Today, one and all, marketing is a very interesting subject for all kinds of commerce students. Marketing is the process where the marketers are making their strategies based on consumer. As far as this video is concerned, we are going to cover about the topic consumer behavior and the factors affecting consumer behavior. This video will make the marketers understand what are the various things which they should keep in mind before making any kind of strategy. So let's start. Consumer is known as king of the market. At the same time, we can say that without consumer, there cannot be any market, there will not be any kind of marketing. So his behavior is very important to be known by each and every marketer. So consumer behavior includes four elements. Number one element is thought, second is feelings, third is decisions, and finally it is an action. That means first consumer thinks that whether he should buy the product or not. The second element comes as feelings. That means what he feels, whether he has a desire to buy or he doesn't have desire, or even whether he needs to buy or he doesn't need to buy. Then he proceeds to the decision, whether to buy the product or not to buy the product, that comes later on. And finally, he takes an action of buying or not buying. Many a times, consumer may think of buying the product. He may be having a feeling that he is in the need of the product. He may be taking a decision to buy the product, but he may not be in a position to take the action. So it is a marketer who is influencing consumer in all these four stages. Marketer have to make the consumer to think for the product. Marketer have to influence the consumer that they should feel that it is desirable to buy the product. Then marketer should influence them to take a decision to buy the product. And finally, marketer have to influence the consumer to take the action in favor of buying the product. So this entire thing is called as consumer behavior, and all these marketers, all these manufacturers, they are having their own strategies to influence the consumer behavior. But still, consumer is a human being. We cannot control the human mind. So it is very much necessary to understand what are the various things which are affecting the consumer behavior. Philip Kotler has defined consumer behavior as, he says, consumer buying behavior refers to the buying behavior of final consumer. Those individuals and household who buy goods and services for personal consumption. That means Philip Kotler is focusing the person who is a final user of the product is called as the consumer. And his decisions, his behavior is very important. Philip Kotler has written 13 volumes on marketing. And the first volume of marketing definition is totally different from the definition of marketing which he has covered in volume number 13. Because he also realized that there is a tremendous change from years together. And it is the consumer who is making the marketer to make a change in the definition. So the final definition, Philip Kotler says that consumer behavior means the behavior of the final user of your product. So all the marketers have to focus on the final user of the product. Lauren has given definition about consumer behavior by adding two more points. He says consumer behavior is the action and a decision process of people who purchase goods and services for personal consumption. That means Lauren has agreed with Philip Kotler that consumer is a person who is a final user of your product. And at the same time, he added two things into that, that is action and a decision. So all the marketers have to focus and have to influence the actions and decisions of the consumer.
if you recollect some type of advertisement, you may realize that all these marketers are making advertisements in such a way that people, those who are not even in a need to buy the product, they also go in the market and they buy the product because they make a decision and they take the action. This is how the marketers are influencing consumer behavior. Consumer is a person who is actually commanding the entire market. So the behavior of the consumer is differ from person to person. There are certain types of consumer behaviors. The first one is routine response or programmed behavior. The name itself says that it is a programmed one. That means it is a fixed one. There is no need to influence the consumer. Consumer go to the market, he buy the particular brand of product and he comes back. There is no need to influence. Generally, this particular behavior of consumer will be noticed when the consumer is buying the daily or routine things like toothbrush, toothpaste, salt or any other thing which he is buying on regular basis. So there is no need for the consumer to make an action properly or to make a proper decision what brand he has to buy and all, nothing. That is called as routine response. The another one is limited decision making. Limited decision making is the behavior of the consumer for the products which are of daily usable but not purchased on daily basis. For example, clothes. A consumer may be buying the clothes even after 1 month or after 2 months or after 3 months. In India, majority of the consumers, they buy the clothes after every 3 months or after every 6 months. So his behavior is little different while buying the clothes. If he is going to buy the toothbrush, the behavior is different. If he is going to buy one shirt or sari or anything, his behavior is different. That is called as limited decision making. That means the things are very much useful or very much in use on the routine basis, but he is not buying it on regular basis. That is called as limited decision making. The third one is extensive decision making. This particular behavior of consumer is noticed when he is buying a very expensive or very luxurious item. For example, car. Even a rich person, when he is buying a car, he can repeat the process after at least 1 year. But a middle class person, he is buying a car and after 5 years only he will think of buying a new car. So his behavior of buying a car is totally different. That is called as extensive decision making. Now in all these three, you can see that as far as routine response is concerned, the marketer doesn't need to make more efforts to influence the consumer because he knows that consumer is going to buy. As far as second thing is concerned, marketers are putting little more efforts to convince the consumer to buy their brand. As far as third is concerned, the marketers are making so many strategies to influence the consumer's decision in their favor. So from stage to stage, the consumer behavior is getting changed and at the same time, the marketer strategy is also getting changed. The last one is impulsive buying. It is a very unique buying behavior. This particular impulsive buying behavior is noticed when they are watching anything very attractive. For example, a consumer, when he goes to shopping mall, he may be seeing so many things and he may be getting influenced to buy the thing which he has not even thought. When he is starting from home to visit a mall, he may not be having a desire to buy a certain thing, but after going in the mall, after getting convinced from the showcasing of the product, he may get convinced to buy that. That is called as impulsive buying behavior. And in India, nowadays, marketers are focusing on that. Somehow they are convincing the customer to make the impulsive decision or impulsive buying decisions. These are called as consumer behaviors types. Consumer is a human being, so his nature is also very moody. Sometime he may be in a very good mood, sometime he may not be in a very good mood. So there are certain factors which are affecting on consumer behavior. Out of these behavior, the first basic is cultural factors. These cultural factors include sub-factors called as culture, subculture, social caste and class, reference group, family, roles and status. These are certain things which are influencing the consumer. For example, family culture. If your family culture is very traditional, you may not be in a position to buy very modern things or very Western things. But if your family is very okay with it, you can buy it. So your culture, a family or the tradition is also responsible to make your decision or to make an action whether to buy or not. Similarly, reference group. Reference group means the group where you are spending most of your time. Your family may be very conservative, but the friends where you are sitting, the place where you are working, all people are very modern. Accordingly, you will take a decision to buy or not to buy. Similarly, roles and status. What kind of status you are having? If you are, or if you are an officer, you cannot travel in bus with your employees. You have to hire your taxi, though you want to travel by bus. But still, your status is not permitting your mind to make a decision to travel by bus. You will go by your car or you will go by your taxi. So these are called as cultural factors which are influencing the consumer behavior. The another factor which is affecting or influencing the consumer behavior are personal factors. These are very common thing. For example, age factor, occupation, lifestyle and personality. If you are a teenager, your behavior of buying the things or thinking on particular product may be different. If you belong to middle age group, your thinking may be different. If you are a very old person, your thinking will be totally different. This is how your age factor is influencing your behavior. Similarly, occupation. If you are in an occupation which is very official or very formal, your behavior will be like that. If you are in a very informal organization, your behavior will be according to that. These are personal factors. Similarly, lifestyle and personality is also defining what sort of behavior you are going to perform as far as consumer role is concerned. The third factor is psychological factors. This is very much necessary for every marketer to understand that what sort of psychological factors a consumer is going through. The first factor is learning. Learning means how we are learning the things or how we are proceeding or having perception about certain things. Sometimes a person who is very rich but very educated may be very down to earth, may be very simple. Sometimes a person who may not be earning very high income but may be having very high thinking for the modernization, or as far as the westernization is concerned, he may be having very western in nature. So he is thinking in that way and accordingly he is performing his behavior. Then attitude. Attitude can be positive or negative. If a consumer is having positive attitude, of course he will get influenced with the strategies adopted by marketer. If the consumer already is having negative opinion about any product, whatever the marketer will do, the consumer will not get convinced. Then motives. What sort of motives one consumer is having in his mind, that is also defining how he is going to behave of buying or not buying. Perception, already we have discussed in the learning point. Then beliefs. What sort of beliefs one consumer is having for one particular brand. If I am having belief in one particular brand name, I will always buy. There is no need which is going to prevent me to buy that thing. Similarly, if one person is having a very negative feeling or negative belief about one particular brand, he will never buy what sort of the strategies marketer is going to apply for. Then another factor is situational factors. These are very interesting. As far as situational factors are concerned, these are certain factors which are creating some sort of situation for the consumer to make a decision either positively or negatively. For example, physical surroundings. If you enter into a shop which is very messy, everything is disorganized, the salesman is also not good, and at the same time the ambience is also, you're not happy with it. So you will not prefer to buy. Your behavior of buying decision will be very negative. But if you enter into a shop which is very neat and clean, you find some sort of attraction. if you feel a comfortable atmosphere to buy, 100% you will buy something from that. That is physical surrounding. Then social surroundings, how the people are behaving in that particular shop, the salesman, or you can say that the staff, the other consumers which are already there, their behavior is also affecting your behavior. So if you feel that the staff is very good and they are supportive and they are making you understand what sort of decision you have to have, your decision will be always positive for you. Then time factor. If you are in a need to buy an umbrella in the rainy season, no matter what, you will buy whatever umbrella is available in the shop. So even time factor is also important to make your decision. Then mood of the consumer. It is actually a psychological type of factor which is influencing on our buying behavior, but it is situational also in nature. In some situation we may be very happy, we may be buying anything. In some situation we may not be in a very good mood, we may not be in a good mood to buy anything, so we will not buy. So it is the situation also which is affecting the consumer behavior. The last is marketing factors. These are the factors which are created by the marketer. It includes product, price, promotion and place. In simple terms we can say that these are the marketing mix elements. If the product is good, the features are very good, if you feel that the product is very useful for you, your decision will be to buy it. If you feel the price is also affordable, you will buy it. If you feel that the promotion also has been made in a very nice manner and you are convinced with the presentation, you will buy it. And finally, the place, that means where you want to buy, the things are available, definitely your decision will be to buy in a positive manner. So these are the factors which are called as marketing factors, and according to me, it is a marketer who is responsible for creating these things. If the marketer is able to make you understand what are the additional features which he has added in the product, if he is making you understand that the price is also quite low or very affordable price, if he is making you understand that the others are also using this product very convenient manner, and if he is making you sure that the things will be available at your place, definitely you are going to buy it. These are called as marketing factors which are influencing the consumer buying behavior. I hope you have understood the concept of marketing behavior very clearly. Ultimately, we can conclude that consumer behavior means how the consumer is making a decision whether to buy or not, and how he is taking the action of buying or not. Sometimes it has been noticed that after making a decision in the positive manner of buying the product, consumers are changing their mind of not to take action of buying it. So one marketer have to be very careful, and marketer have to make sure that consumer is making an action also in a positive manner of buying their product or their brand. This is all about consumer behavior. Thank you so much.